Interstitial cystitis in women. Interstitial cystitis or IC is a complex condition that is identified by chronic inflammation of the bladder muscle layers. Discomfort can range from a mild burning sensation to severe pain. The degree of discomfort can be persistent or infrequent. Women are most likely to develop IC, but children and adult men can get it as well. IC is also known as painful bladder syndrome, bladder pain syndrome, and chronic pelvic pain. About 90% of the patients of interstitial cystitis are women. It has become so prevalent in today's world that people have organized an IC Awareness Week in its name, because research says IC patients are often wrongly diagnosed with some other disease. But if you know about this disease, its causes and its risk factors, then it becomes easier for you and your physician to treat interstitial cystitis. Now let's get started with our today's video on interstitial cystitis in women. What causes interstitial cystitis in women? The exact cause of IC isn't known, but researchers postulate that several factors may damage the lining of the bladder and therefore trigger the disorder. These include trauma to the bladder lining, excessive stretching of the bladder, usually due to long periods without a bathroom break, weakened or dysfunctional pelvic floor muscles, autoimmune disorders, repeated bacterial infections, hypersensitivity or inflammation of pelvic nerves, spinal cord trauma. Many people with IC also have irritable bowel syndrome. Some researchers believe that IC may be part of a generalized inflammatory disorder that affects multiple organ systems in the body. Researchers are also investigating the possibility that people may inherit IC genetically. Although it's not common, IC has been reported in blood relatives. Research is ongoing to determine the cause of IC and to develop more effective treatments. You also need to remember symptoms may worsen if a person with interstitial cystitis gets a urinary tract infection. Who is at risk? Some people might have higher chances of getting diagnosed with IC. If you fall under the categories that we are going to mention right now, and if you are experiencing these symptoms too, then you might need to consider going to a doctor for a checkup. These factors are associated with a higher risk of interstitial cystitis. Your gender. Women are diagnosed with interstitial cystitis more often than men. Symptoms in men may mimic interstitial cystitis, but they're more often associated with an inflammation of the prostate gland. Your skin and hair color. Having fair skin and red hair has been associated with a greater risk of interstitial cystitis. Your age. Most people with interstitial cystitis are diagnosed during their 30s or older. Having a chronic pain disorder. Interstitial cystitis may be associated with other chronic pain disorder, such as irritable bowel syndrome or IBS. How is it diagnosed? There are no tests that make a definitive diagnosis of IC. So many cases of IC go undiagnosed because IC shares many of the same symptoms of other bladder disorders. Your doctor needs to rule them out first. These other disorders include urinary tract infections, bladder cancer, chronic prostatitis, which occurs in men, chronic pelvic pain syndrome, which occurs in men, endometriosis, which occurs in women. You'll be diagnosed with IC once your doctor determines that your symptoms aren't due to one of these disorders. Since there are no diagnostic tests, IC is mainly diagnosed by observing and monitoring the symptoms only. What are the available treatment options? There is no cure or definitive treatment for IC. Most people use a combination of treatments, and you may have to try several approaches before you settle on the therapy that provides the most relief. Medication. Your doctor may prescribe one or more of the following drugs to help improve your symptoms. Pentosan polysulfate sodium. Doctors are not sure about the exact method of action of this medicine, but it may help repair tears or defects in the bladder wall. Pregnant women should not go for this drug. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatories. These are taken to subdue the inflammation that might occur in the bladder walls. Antihistamines. These help decrease urinary urgency and frequency. Bladder distension. Bladder distension is a procedure that stretches the bladder using water or gas. It can help relieve symptoms in some people, possibly by increasing the capacity of the bladder and by interrupting pain signals transmitted by nerves in the bladder. Electrical nerve stimulation. It may help relieve symptoms by increasing blood flow to the bladder, strengthening pelvic muscles that help control the bladder, or triggering the release of substances in your body that block pain. Surgery. There are several surgical options to increase the size of the bladder and remove or treat ulcers in the bladder. Surgery is rarely used and is considered only when symptoms are severe and other treatments have failed to provide relief. Interstitial cystitis can be a very painful disease, and your only safe bet is to combat its symptoms. Take care of your hygiene, quit smoking, look after your diet, and also reduce stress in your life to prevent worsening of your symptoms. Remember, you're not alone. We hope you found this video informative and do recommend it to other friends. Thanks for watching. That's all from us today. We want you to know that your voice is important to us. So please leave a comment below. If you are new here, then click the bell icon for notifications of our new videos. And subscribe to our channel. For more content, visit our website www.thevoiceofwoman.com. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and let your voice be heard.